Hey, make sure you get my good side.
Viva la Ultraflex. Where's my camera?
Can we start doing these intros now?
Can you get out of the way?
Excuse me, please.
Hello and welcome to another YouTube video. So an exciting one today. We are at Ultraflex Derby. This is the first time, it's brand new Ultraflex, the first time we've been up here, and we're going to be training some posh. So we're going to have a go of some machines that potentially we haven't used before, or some really fucking good ones that I might have come across. I'm just going to experiment, have a good time, lift some heavy fucking weight. I'll give you an update of what I've been up to as well. So I maxed out my weight at around about 263, it's roughly like 120 kilo. I got to the position where food, I was just redlining, like I was having to sort of wake up at 6 and start my day of eating, and that was not finishing until like 1 or 2, which was obviously difficult, but it's when I started throwing up. Like I was throwing up after meals, and that was telling me, okay, I'm now doing something that's very, very unproductive. So we pulled back. I was uncomfortable for a while before that. You've got to be uncomfortable somewhat to a point to actually make big changes to your physique, and you can do it to the extent of being unproductive. So we've pulled back 10 days. I'll get Mitch to put some photos for context. I've dropped around about 12 pounds. Peak calories like 5,300, and then we dropped down to like 3,000. That came down very fast, but I feel like a million times better. So what we're gonna do now is just slowly escalate the food. We're actually gonna de-escalate the gear so that we slowly drop it into a cruise phase. Hold on to a nice tight composition, and it's all gonna contribute towards a nice, healthy starting position for the start of prep. Yeah, I would say the big bulk is over. If we can return back to the 260s in a decent, nice lean composition, then that's been a hell of a productive off season. Absolutely. Like I say, I feel a million times fucking better. Strength still obviously nice and high. There's no reason why it shouldn't be. So we're gonna have a fucking great session. Let's go.
Shoulder session, machine side raises. There's a lot of equipment that I haven't tried before, sort of different pieces. So we've just had a feel around, see what sort of feels best. At the moment, I'm quite liking the Atlantis side raise. So we're gonna start with that. Cage is gonna be using a different machine. But again, it's like itself, because we're just having a go with things. We're having a good time, seeing what feels best and just trying shit out. We're just gonna get a juicy fucking pump.
It's just fun. It's fun to be on. Like, I could do this all day. It's like a fucking rocking chair. I'm like, ooh, back in my day, we just used to have a fucking sick time at the gym. I could do this all day. Okay, I'm gonna stop now. Nice. I haven't used much hoist equipment, but obviously from the feeling set, that felt good. That felt great. In fact, the only time I've actually used hoist equipment was at Gold's Gym in Venice, when I went over there to compete. The thing is, hoist sort of boosts as you do the movement, and that way you can get like a really great connection. It just keeps it on the muscle. So I'm excited, man. I'm just excited. I love a day. This is a day out for me, guys. Me going to a different fucking gym with shiny equipment. You know, that, you'll notice that we're just traveling to a couple of different gyms lately because, again, just to keep things fresh, exciting, try new things, meet new people, see new things. And yeah, man. Okay, we're about to do a working rocking horse set.
gone for the Nautilus Nitro just because this shit converges and it feels fucking nice. If you've tried any of the Nautilus sort of Nitro pieces, you know, it just feels great. A classic, classic machine. Guys over there, they're using the Atlantis shoulder press. It's a plate loading. In my opinion, it's very similar, except for that one doesn't sort of converge. You know, like I say, we've just tried out different pieces today. I'll be using this. Stack is quite fucking light. That's probably the issue with pin loaded over plate loaded. With plate loaded, there's more room to sort of load more load. But have no fear. The gym pin is here. We're going to whack this in, whack a couple of plates on, and we should be able to get a very sexual set in. Like a fourth place fitting on. I'm gonna try to see if I can fit a fourth on. If not, I'm not gonna be ridiculous and say three plates. I could absolutely not get a plate on. So we'll see if we can get a fourth on. That should do it. I don't have to fucking try to do a six wrapper. At the end of the day, I just wanted to feel good and to be hard enough to be intense. Fuck me. Okay, that's just gonna pull off all the plates. Just ranting about people leaving fucking plates on the machines, man. That's one thing that Strength's got, is they seem to be like a universally agreed thing that people put the fucking weights back. Like, when a machine's like fully fucking loaded, you go on it. I'd say, like, if you're like a fucking, I don't know, 40, 50 kilo female, it's gonna be a ball ache to pull that off and then load it back up. Try 7, see what we can do. I'm just gonna do one to feel it. I don't, if there's room for 8, I don't wanna take that away. Eight! Yes, okay! Oh, yes.
Nice.
Ooh, with you.
Oh.
Hop! God, that felt very sexual. Very, very sexual. You ready?
What? Mike?
Come on then. Nice. Hop! Yes! Well done. Yeah. Boom! Oh, yes. Fucking nice. So we finish up the pressing with a flat press. Again, going back to the Nautilus Nitro. It was a tough decision between this and the gym Leco. Tried it out. It was okay. But this just feels fucking sexy. It feels sexy. And again, I just love the fact that it converges very nicely. So we're going to give it a go. With me. With you now. Fuck me. Yep. And again, lads, come on. All the fucking way. Hurry on. Drive. Nice. That was great, mate. Okay, really fucking sick session. So we're finishing off with back on this machine, but we're just going to do muscle rounds. So we're going failure point, left, right, left, right. Finish off the side delts, then we've got some triceps. But I got to say, man, I'm impressed, man, because there's you're spoilt for choice. There's a lot of variety. So if you... Like, I've been able to be a really picky motherfucker in this gym. I've been able to go on a machine and I'm like, oh, this is nice, but I like this because it does this. Or I'm like, I like this because it's like this. You know what I mean? Or it drops off, you know. So it's I've been able to be nice and picky and just have the session that I fucking want. And same with the rest of the people I've been training with. And see some familiar faces, said hello. And that's the beauty of a change of scenery. Gives new opportunities. Just network, catch up with people, see how they're doing. Obviously, you can chat with these people on social media, but it's always good to catch up in person, see how they're doing, and probably arrange some fucking cheeky cameo sessions with these motherfuckers. I digress. Let's go around. Tricky steps. Whoa. So we'll finish off a couple of tricep exercises. My notice, I've got like a massive cum stain on. It's not a cum stain, it's bird shit. But like, I just spilt something on my t-shirt right before I fucking came. I didn't change my t-shirt. I was desperate to represent like Titan Soul, so this is, to be honest, it's like a style, you know? Bit of a patterning. Looks fucking dreadful, don't it? There's something different about this fucking lighting, bro. That is the end of another YouTube video. I hope you guys have enjoyed it. I hope you've had some shit to take away from it, you know, picked up something new. And stay tuned for more. Let me know if there's anything else you want to see. Like, comment, subscribe, all that jazz. And have a good life. Make the most of it, okay? Dare to dream. Be bigger. Be bolder. Bombastic.